Hello friends, welcome to Global Tech Learn. In this video, we will attempt Microsoft PowerBI PL 300 exam question related to denormalize the data. So the question is, you create a data model in PowerBI. Report developers and users provide feedback that the data model is too complex. The model contains the following tables and relationships. And on the right side in exhibit, we can see we have four tables: sales region, region manager, sales manager, and manager. And the relationship between these tables is given as there is a one-to-one relationship between sales region and region manager. There are more records in manager than in region manager, but every record in region manager has a corresponding record in manager. There are more records in sales manager than in sales region, but every record in sales region has a corresponding record in sales manager. You need to denormalize the model into a single table. Only managers who are associated to a sales region must be included in the report. Which three actions should you perform in sequence? So now let's try to understand the question. Now here, if we look at the exhibit, we have four tables, and in these tables we have ID fields such as region ID, manager ID. These are the IDs based on that these tables has relationship. And as per the requirement, we had to merge all those tables in a single table so we can have denormalized data. And it will remove the complexity from the model, as we will create only one table with all the data. Now, as per the given data, we have to identify how we can merge these tables. So now let's go to the data and let's try to understand what kind of relationship these tables should have. So here in Power BI model, we can see we have four tables, and let's try to create a relationship between these tables. So for that, here we can see in manager table has manager ID, and similar manager ID we can see in region manager. So let's try to establish a relationship. And here we can see we are getting one-to-one relationship. Now from region manager to sales region, we have region ID as the common key. So let's create relationship. And from sales region to sales manager, we can see we have region ID as the common ID. We can create relationship from there. Now here we can see relationship among three tables, manager, region manager, and sales region is the one-to-one. And the only difference is from sales region to sales manager, there is a one-to-many. So now let's go to the data, and here as per the given case, manager has more records than region manager. So under manager we can see we have three records, and under region manager we have just two records. And the next detail we have is there are more records in sales manager than in sales region. Let's verify that. So in sales region we have two records, and under sales manager we have three records. So we are meeting that requirement as well. So now here in model, we can see how the data is flowing. So now from manager to region manager, it is one-to-one relationship. From region manager to sales region, it is one-to-one relationship. And as per the requirement, we have to merge all those tables, and we have to ignore the record from manager table. Those are not associated with the region ID in region manager. So since we have one-to-one relationship between manager and region manager, so it will get excluded, as it will not find the respective manager ID in region manager. Now let's go to transform editor and let's try to merge these tables. So here in transform editor, we can merge manager to the region manager. So let's try to merge that. So here we have region manager, and then we have to click on merge queries, and here we have to select the manager table, and we have manager ID as the common key, and here we want to merge it based on the inner join. Before click on OK, here let's verify we have two records, that is manager ID 1 and 2 in region manager, and under manager table we have three records, and as per the given requirement we need to ignore the extra record, that is manager ID 3. So let's click on the OK and let's verify the data. So here we can see we are getting just two records, and let me expand the merge table columns, and here we are getting just two records, that is manager ID 1 and 2, and manager ID 3 has been removed because of inner merge. Now let's look at the model again. And as per the model, we have merged manager and region manager. Now let's try to merge sales region and sales manager. So for that, let's go to the sales region and let's click on merge. And we want to merge it with the sales manager. And the common key is region ID. And this also should be merged based on inner. And let's click on the OK. Now let's expand all the fields. Now here under sales region, we have one merge table and another merge table we have in region manager. Now we have merged four tables in two tables, or we can say we have denormalized data partially, and we have merged data in sales region and the region manager. And as per the given requirement, we need one table as a denormalize that developers can use for their development. Now we need to merge region manager and sales region. So for that, let's click on merge. And here we have to select the sales region. And the common ID is region ID. And over here you can see we have two records in each table. So either we can go with left outer join or inner join, we will get same result. But for now, let's select the inner join. As per the condition, we have to ignore manager without any region ID. And so in future, if any new record arrives with a new manager name without region ID, so that will get filtered out. And let's click on the OK. Now we have final table region master, where we have all the data as denormalized. And this denormalized region manager table developers can use for their development. So now let's go back to the question. Let's look at the options, because the options are a bit confusing. So the first option is merge region manager and the manager. So that is correct. We merge these two tables based on inner join. We can mark this option as correct. The second option is merge sales manager and sales region using left join. So this is incorrect, as we merged based on the inner join. So we can skip this option. Then option C is merge sales region and sales manager by using inner join. So that is correct. These are the other two tables that we merge using the inner join. Then the third option is merge sales region, sales manager using inner join as a new query. So we didn't use new query. We merge within the same table. So we can ignore this option. Otherwise, if we have selected the new query, then we have to give this name sales region and manager, and all the rest of the merge we had to do on this query only. But we didn't do that, so we can ignore this. And the option E is merge sales region and region manager by using right join. So this is also incorrect, as we didn't use right join and we use inner join to ignore one manager who don't have any region ID. And the last option is merge sales region and region manager by using inner join. So this is the correct option. As we merge sales region and sales manager, sales region, and region manager and manager in the region manager. And at the end, we merge these two tables together using the inner join. So we can mark this option as the correct answer. Now let's understand this question with performance perspective, as the same question was asked in Microsoft PL 300 exam with one additional requirement, that is we have to keep model size minimum. So for that, once we have merged all those tables in single table, thereafter if we see the same data what we have merged in a denormalized table is available in base table as well, like a manager table has manager ID and manager name, and all this data is available in region manager. Similarly, for sales manager, all the information available over here is the available region manager. That means we need only region manager, and all other tables has the duplicate data. We don't want that tables to hold this data, as it will increase the model size. For that, we can disable the data load in this table. So as a best practice, on this base tables, there is option to enable load that we can disable. So now once we click on this disable, then if you see now the table name has italic font, that means when this model will get refreshed, the data will load in manager table, but once it passed to the region manager denormalized table, it will flush out from the manager table. So with this, the model size will be reduced and we will have a good performance from Power BI model.